Hello, you're watching our series on Service Management and Orchestration, the keys to Open RAN's success. I'm Guy Daniels, Director of Content at TelecomTV. And joining me now is Deepak Shahani, VP and GM Service Enablement Business at VIAVI Solutions. Deepak, very good to see you. Well, let me first of all ask you, why is VIAVI Solutions partnering with Ericsson for RApps for its SMO?
So very happy to be here. VIAVI and Ericsson, we have a long partnership spanning from the joint research we did in Ericsson in the Horizon 2020 programs. And we have been suppliers to them for the internal usage of our test and measurement gear. We also have joint solutions with them for mobile operators where we utilize their best-in-class call trace features for both the RAN and the core. So we've worked with Ericsson for a long time. It was a no-brainer for us to engage with Ericsson on the SMO, as clearly this is the next evolution in the industry and will allow us together to deliver further value to our joint customer base.
And what is the main value that your customers will get from the VIAVI Solutions RApps?
Sure. Customers today can access our very, very rich subscriber-specific geolocation capabilities, right? So we have assets like our VIAVI Nitro mobile platform through which we do that. But now by moving this capability within an RApp, within the Ericsson SMO, customers will now be able to effectively create what we call custom pipelines to utilize this amazing precise intelligence from one RApp to many other RApps in a single platform, the Ericsson Intelligent Automation Platform. It's a very powerful concept. So from our point of view, the geolocation RApp is a foundational capability that can be reused in the overall SMO system by any number of RApps, right, and deliver very precise subscriber-specific geolocation. It's very accurate and therefore can give you a lot of real-time outcomes, which you couldn't do before. So a joint offering, which allows customers to extract a wealth of information through the selection of RApps and lower the cost of managing independent systems, right, and therefore eliminating the need to integrate them on their own, I think is the key value that they get out of this. It's something that is built into the system from day one, and something that everybody can access at any time.
And you mentioned that some of the RApps will be foundational and provide subscriber geolocation information, and that this can be used by the platform and the ecosystem, whether VIAVI, Ericsson, or third parties. Can you tell me more about the evolution of RApps from VIAVI and how they form into overall solutions for operator customers?
In terms of specific capabilities such as geolocation or even possibly a network digital twin, they are foundational to the platform because they can be reused across any number of use cases and pipelines, right? And the big difference now is that as we insert this capability into Ericsson's platform, this is a best-in-class capability, but it's also now in real time. And so now VIAVIs will be sort of enabling a lot of innovation happening around these new use cases by reusing both the geolocation capability, the digital twin assets that we have, right, along with the other RApps in Ericsson's SMO system. This journey is just getting started, right? And we will work jointly with our customers and with Ericsson to further figure out what else we could do around these and ensure that the challenges that are going to come up from 5G with the millimeter wave solutions coming out in the future, how we can address them in the most efficient manner possible.
And when can we expect to see the initial delivery of these solutions? And when can we start to really understand in more detail the value that this will provide to the ecosystem?
We expect the first proof of concept to be shown very shortly through a blog post on Ericsson website. And we are working jointly with Ericsson to solidify and ensure that the delivery of the complete use case is aligned with Ericsson release plans for their SMO functionality. So all this, these solutions we're talking about would be available to our customers imminently.
So Deepak, the evolution taking place here will cover the whole installed base of Ericsson RAN infrastructure, not only the Open RAN portions. What value do you think this can bring to the market?
So VIAVI has been a member and a supporter of O-RAN Alliance since its inception, right? We strongly believe in the joint industry effort happening in this area. But let's remember that even if Open RAN based networks show tremendous potential, right, in next years, a vast majority of networks today and for the foreseeable future are based on purpose-built technology, right? So regardless of whether purpose-built or Cloud RAN or whatever succeeds, Ericsson's market leadership in the RAN space with a significant installed base is just going to, you know, expand with the value of SMO offering and the RApps to be realized by hundreds of operators who use Ericsson's technology today, covering billions of subscribers. So in our estimation, right, this provides VIAVI with a unique opportunity to deliver our high value capability to many more customers in many more regions than we could do otherwise, historically speaking.
Deepak, thank you very much indeed for joining us on the program today and sharing your views with us. Now, don't forget, you can watch more programs in our Strategy Outlook series on service management and orchestration, the keys to Open RAN success, right here on Telecom TV. For now, though, thank you for watching and goodbye.